All right, the E36 is back in the garage. This time I'm trying to fix a minor leak fault in the Evap system. This is a similar fault to what you might experience if you leave the gas cap off. But essentially this system is, the fuel system is completely sealed, and you can see on the diagram you have the fuel tank down here. You've got the filler neck and then this tank, which they call the liquid vapor separator. And it isn't just a regular tank, it does have that, serve that function. I call it the expansion tank, but mainly because it's designed to take primarily, you know, gaseous fuel vapor, and then it condenses in the tank and is returned to the tank. So there's actually three nipples on this, three connections on this tank. And again, this is on the top of the tank. There's actually a smaller nipple and a bigger nipple. I'll show that to you in a second. And then there's a smaller nipple on the bottom. So the bottom drains liquid fuel back to the tank, and then fuel vapor condenses in the tank. And then this other one, the bigger of the two, is goes to the charcoal canister, and that vents to atmosphere through the charcoal canister, I believe. And because they don't allow, you know, open venting of the fuel system anymore. So what we have is, this is the old tank. You can see the two nipples on the top, the bigger one and the small one. You can see the bigger one is a little canted to one side, and that's actually because it's broken. Of course, I think I broke it when I was trying to remove it, not that it was necessarily broken when I found it. It was kind of bent or curved, but it wasn't like, it wasn't kinked, so I don't know exactly whether that this actually will fix the problem. But on the bottom of it, you've got the lower nipple, which of course drains liquid fuel back to the tank. There are a lot of different ways to fix this. I decided to kind of kill two birds with one stone, and I bought a new tank and used this JB Weld product. It's a what they call, I think, a steel stick. It's essentially a JB Weld product, except in a kind of a resin type form. And I just found that it would just, without making a big mess, it would just kind of stick where I wanted to put it. And I just reinforced both of those tubes. So they're, you know, this is a brand new tank. Obviously, those nipples aren't broken. You can apparently repair the old tanks, but I just decided to, like I did with my door panels, I kind of just prophylactically applied a fix. So hopefully that will not happen again for another 18 years. You can also tell the old nipples kind of discolored, that white nylon or whatever material. Maybe just high-density polyethylene, or I'm not sure exactly what the nipple's made of, but you can tell the other one was discolored, and this one's pure white. So, first of all, you can see I've removed this. I've removed this rubber seal. You can just literally grab it and pull it right out. It's got a little drain on the bottom of it, so in case anyone gets, you know, water and or I guess fuel possibly, but mostly water, it'll just drain out the bottom of it. There's no hose attached to that. And as we get underneath it, you can see this is the 8x13 line that goes to the top. See if I can show you here. It reaches over and around the back of this filler neck. That's an 8x13 fuel hose. And then we have these two fuel hoses over here, one with a very short piece on it, and one with a little bit longer piece. These are again both 6x11 millimeter fuel hoses. And these are brand new. I've replaced these. I'm replacing all of the hose back here, with the exception of this hose, because it's like you can only buy a full length of this. I need 3 inches of it. You have to buy a full length of like 3 feet, and it's about $45. And generally speaking, I found by replacing this hose, I found this hose to be excellent quality. I'm actually very surprised that it's in as good a shape as it is after 18 years. So I nevertheless replaced it with new BMW original hose. You basically buy this stuff in 1 meter lengths or 3 foot lengths, and it's not cheap, but it lasts. But anyway, this is the this 8mm, 8x13mm hose transitions to this blue plastic hose or what have you, and that goes to the charcoal canister. And it has to be behind, when you reinstall it, it has to be kind of behind that so it reaches over and touches and mates with the tank up there in that recess. And these two obviously mate to the tank as well. This one has got to go kind of up and over and again get to the tank. I have to look at my original pictures to see whether it actually, I don't want to put it like that because it would rub against this hard metal. I'm going to probably tie wrap it or something to here. There was no tie wraps on it before, but I want to make sure this doesn't go and rub up against anything. That would be a bad thing. But anyway, this I would have loved to have replaced this thing with all of this rust, but I got a price on this, and it's like, you know, my cost is like $450 or something like that. Certainly not worth it, but especially since it looks like such a cheap plastic molding. I don't know what they were thinking when they built this thing, but could have made it a lot better material. But anyway, this filler neck goes down to a flexible hose that attaches to the fuel tank, and that's how you get fuel into your car. So this is a pressure sensor that monitors pressure. Every time you drive the car, it goes through when you go through a drive cycle, it actually allows the tank to pressurize, then it opens the purge valve, and this pressure sensor monitors essentially the rate of decrease in pressure. If there's no change, then it assumes it's a major leak. If it changes over a particular time frame and a particular threshold, it considers it a major leak, or a minor leak rather. And anyway, this is where the sensor for that is. It has obviously an electrical connection here, and then this pre-molded pipe. I guess you could possibly use a standard 6x11 fuel hose for this, but it's definitely pre-molded for a reason. It's in tight quarters up there, and I think it might get a little unwieldy and put a lot of stress on the nipples, etc., if you try to just use a regular hose. But you probably, in a pinch, could use 6x11 if you really wanted to. But I was going to replace this. It's over $200. I have no idea why. I mean, that's high even for BMW. But it's got a Siemens label on it and a BMW label on it, so I guess that's all you need. So anyway, that's the plan, is to replace the tank today, and hopefully that will fix the problem. I also have a new purge valve I'm going to install as well. Mostly, I didn't get a code on that or anything like that, but mainly because it's 18 years old, and it is something I need to check. So, by the way, the purge valve is located on the intake manifold, and I'll take you over there now. All right, we're over in the engine bay, and I just wanted to show you the location of the purge valve. This is mounted via this rubber isolation mount to the intake manifold. And of course, that's just used to open the fuel system to the vacuum in the intake manifold so that it can draw down the pressure in the system. And then, of course, the pressure sensor monitors the rate of change of that pressure, and in that process can determine whether there's a leak in the system. So that's pretty much it. I am replacing this part, but I wouldn't necessarily recommend or suggest it has to be replaced unless there's a code for it. It's fully instrumented, so if it isn't responding, you will get a code. The DME will know that it's not operational. But anyway, that's pretty much it. Hopefully this will fix the problem. If not, I'll be back in the garage soon. All right, one other thing. I was in the process of installing the tank. I just kind of wanted to show you the fact that I happen to use a worm drive clamp on the 8x13 because that's what I had available. And then I ordered a bunch of these one-time use clamps that are suitable for the 6x11, and I just installed that. I found putting this pressure sensor onto the new unit required like a channel lock to just kind of squeeze this together. There was a gap here, obviously, and then
There are these barbs that are attached to this piece. They're part of the tank mounting assembly, and they have to go through the holes in the sensor. And, you know, I really had to squeeze them with something. I couldn't push them together with my hands, so I was just very careful. I used a small channel lock. I happened to tape the jaws as well, just for extra protection, so I didn't mar anything up. And then I secured it. My original concern for, that I mentioned earlier about this hose getting, you know, kind of pinched or rubbed up against that sharp metal, turns out to be not an issue, because this actually comes in front of this larger tube here. And what I didn't realize at the time, it's easier to see in the old tank now that it's out, there's this barb on the back of the tank, and that actually fits into that hole. So my only recommendation is, when you're putting this back together, look through the fuel port, the filler port, and make sure that you are not crimping this hose anywhere. I noticed when I initially did a test fitting just a second ago, it was squeezing up against the back of the tank, and you don't want that. So I'm going to grab some tie wraps and put this hose exactly where I want it to be, so it doesn't rub up against the metal of these connectors, etc. And that should wrap it up.